Hello, high school football fans. It's Bob Sakamoto again from the Chicago Tribune. To those of you on my blog, The Inside Scoop, I'm known simply as Sacco, and I had a wonderful weekend of high school football beginning on Friday night in Frankfurt when I covered the Naperville North Lincoln Way East game. Two tremendous defenses. I haven't seen a defensive battle like that in a long time. Unfortunately, Lincoln Way East coughed up the ball. In fact, they fumbled three times in the first five plays, and Naperville North took advantage of that, as well as two more fumbles later on, and rolled to a 21-7 victory in their state quarterfinals in Class 8A. On Saturday, I got to spend the whole day and all night at Gately Stadium in the south side of Chicago to watch two football games that I really wanted to see. The first one in the afternoon, Mount Carmel against Maine South. Two traditional big school powers, Mount Carmel with the option running offense, Maine South with a terrific passing offense with Charlie Goro. Great contrast of styles. And coming up big in this game, Glenn Foster, who hadn't played well all season long. He made three sacks, was behind the line of scrimmage all day long, disrupting Maine South's offense. And I asked Mount Carmel coach Frank Lenti afterwards, was this the best game of the season for Glenn Foster? Lenti looked at me and smiled and said, it's the only game of the season so far. So you know they were giving it to Glenn a little bit, but he came up big for Mount Carmel in a win over Maine South. Then the nightcap, Wheaton-Warrenville South against Morgan Park, the defending 8A champion Tigers taking on Morgan Park, the last team left in the public league, a big, powerful team, three offensive linemen that weigh over 300 pounds. And sure enough, Wheaton South's quickness controlled Morgan Park's running game. And then Wheaton South made six interceptions. I mean, quite a display of thievery in the secondary and also linebackers. Mark LaBelle had two of the interceptions as Wheaton South rolled 24-0. Taking a look at coming up, the semifinals, we've got some great ones. Mount Carmel goes against Glenn Bard North, the big Cinderella team, one of the two Cinderella teams in 8A. Glenn Bard North just keeps on winning with a bunch of no-name players on offense and defense. We've got Naperville North, another heavy favorite, going to Homewood Flossmoor, number 16-seeded Homewood Flossmoor. That should be a terrific game. In 6A, we got the dream game we've been waiting for. Normal, the 6A champion from last year, against Joliet Catholic, who I consider the best team in 6A this year. This is Bob Sakamoto with the Chicago Tribune. Be sure and click onto my blog, The Inside Scoop. You can reach it at chicagosports.com/Sakamoto. Send in a comment. Let's talk some high school football.